Hey, Matcha. What's the tea? Earlier this week, Dixie D'Amelio kissed Noah Beck in her new music video. Even in the BTS video, Noah caresses her head as they look at each other.
Aww.
Noah also caresses Dixie's arm in the BTS video. People teased Noah and Dixie about claiming they are just friends recently. I swear to God, if they say they're just friends, I'm going to flip. Dixie and Noah's children be like, "Mommy and Daddy are just friends." For context, Dixie recently broke up with Griffin and was seen getting close to their friend Noah. However, Dixie and Noah claim they are just friends in a paparazzi video.
Are you friendly?
BFFs.
Dixie's an amazing girl. She is a friend.
Anyway, back to the current story. People had mixed feelings about Dixie's music video. I wouldn't be laid up on a dude like that, then kiss him if we weren't a thing. Everyone, they can't just be friends. Me. So you're telling me that any actor who kissed someone in a movie is dating them? What's interesting is, Noah denied any relationship when asked by paparazzi photographer Kevin Wong about the kiss.
Yeah, tell us about that, man. Music video, I mean.
Dixie also explained why she chose Noah in a YouTube Live.
So, I had a lot of choices of like people to be in the video, and they were all like, it was weird because I didn't want to just pick like someone I didn't know, because the whole idea was I had to be like with this person, and I didn't want it to be someone I didn't know because I'm very awkward, and it would be weird if I was just like met someone random.
Then, Griffin Johnson spoke up. He posted these tweets the same day Dixie released her music video. Here we go again. Time to spice things up. You're welcome in advance. You may remember, Dixie recently announced that she and Griffin Johnson broke up in a YouTube video titled My Last Date with Griffin.
Hey, so we actually broke up, but I had this video scheduled for today, so I'm posting it anyways.
Anyway, back to the current story. People suspected Griffin's tweets were about Dixie and had mixed feelings about it. Who cares? Everybody should just move on already. Anyways, you made a mistake on losing Dixie, so assume it already and just move on. Wait, are you talking about Dixie and Noah? Because that is so interesting how they are just friends. All my respect and love to Dixie and Noah, but just friends is going too far. You're welcome for what? Embarrassing yourself? Then, Griffin also posted something shocking. Griffin posted a song called Convenient, and the lyrics were about Dixie. She said I cheated, that's just f***ed up, but you believed it, ain't that convenient. He also threw shade at Noah in his song. You don't think I know, but I know a little bit. A lot of people weren't impressed. This song is just him saying the truth about himself and him just saying the same words every 10 seconds when Dixie didn't even make a song of this dude. Personally, I like Dixie and Noah together. It's the jealousy for me. This is stupid. Get over Dixie, Griffin. You cheated on her. Get over her, dude. Y'all are adults. Why is this middle school breakup drama plastered everywhere? Griffin finally unfollowed Dixie. Then, at around 3 a.m., Griffin posted several tweets that may be directed at Dixie and Noah. Cheaters cheat, lovers love, I'm a lover. In a world full of deception, be the person that forgives. I'm setting the record straight, but I've forgiven. Life's too short to hold a grudge. My conscience drives me, not social media comments. No one who practices deceit shall dwell in my house. No one who utters lies shall continue before my eyes. Psalm 101, verse 17. Some people didn't understand why he kept bringing up drama involving Dixie.
I'd say otherwise. I swear you could have avoided this drama again. But no, you have to make the pit bigger and bring up about your cheating. Don't complain because you had it coming for you. This drama was forgotten about. You got away from the hate and were maybe getting 4 or 5 comments about it. You completely embarrassed yourself with this song and will end up with you getting more hate. So don't go crying on social media when you did it to yourself.
There were some people who supported Griffin.
He didn't cheat though. Listen to his song lyrics. From the sounds of it, it looks like Dixie made up that excuse so she could date his best friend. My respect for Noah dropped hard. People are going to be negative no matter what you do. Just focus your energy on the positive and your fans who care about you and your mental health.
But then, something confusing happened. Griffin and Noah were spotted working out together on Instagram Live.
What?
the Hollywood Fix also got involved. The paparazzi asked Noah about Griffin's diss track.
Griffin and I have no beef, there's nothing there.
People thought it was weird that Griffin and Noah were hanging out. That's so awkward. Like, why did Griffin make the song in the first place? This is what makes me think all of this is fake, cause what the f- ain't that convenient. On September 23rd, Dixie shared screenshots in a TikTok video exposing Griffin for cheating. Griffin sent an explicit photo of himself, flirted, and wrote many explicit messages to multiple different girls. Got you. Griffin sending a Snapchat to another girl. Because you're dope, and we have unfinished business. I love bad and they are so hard to find. I hate just wifey. A DM conversation between Griffin and another girl. I want to f*** you so bad. I mean hang.
What?
It shows Griffin asking for a girl's Snapchat, adding her, then sending her a picture. Griffin sends a picture to another girl. Send toes. And another. I'm single, by the way. And another. Sick. See you in. Also in the TikTok, Dixie shows Griffin's apology text. In the text, he says moving forward, he won't speak about Dixie, but we all know that's not true because his most recent song is about her. I am sorry from the bottom of my heart. I'm sorry I handled it incorrectly at first. Moving forward, I do want you to know that I will never say another thing about you, and you do not have to worry. Many influencers commented on Dixie's video, including Charlie D'Amelio, Thomas Petru, and Tana Mojo. This you? So Chase didn't lie. Crazy. This is the best TikTok I've ever seen. Dixie finally unfollowed Griffin. Then, Griffin started tweeting a lot. He spoke about making mistakes and being human. A person isn't defined by how they get kicked down. They're defined by how they get back up. If a person doesn't make mistakes, are they actually a person? No, they're lying. To err is human, to forgive, divine. The truth will set you free, especially if what's out there is half a story. Hand someone a fish, they eat for a day. Let them into your house to learn to fish, they play with your emotions. I admit to f***ing up, I'm not perfect. God knows I'm not even close, but time for others to admit the same. Strong people stand up for themselves, but stronger people stand up for others. New leaf, new me. Can't change the past, but can learn to avoid deja vu. He ended his rant by promoting his merch. Anyways, some people defended Dixie and criticized Griffin. Dixie is doing too much. Where was this energy when Griffin dropped his song? How about when he liked a post shaming her? Or when he repeatedly threw shade at her? Oh, it's okay when that happens. He needs to act his age and own up to his choice instead of act like a victim. People do make mistakes, but usually they act up and don't lie about or even try to be the victim. Grow up, you were the one looking for drama and attention. Congratulations, now you got that. One person supported Griffin. I hope you're doing okay and you guys can leave this alone now. Another person just wanted it to be over. Dixie showed her proof. Griffin wrote his diss track. They said their piece, leave them be. If everyone stopped coming at it and talking about it and the media stops entertaining it, they can get on with their lives. Then, Bryce Hall spoke up. Bryce called out all Hype House members in a Twitter post. Griff f***ed up. Dix clapped back. Move on. All the Hype House members getting involved for clout and acting like they care about the situation should shut the f*** up. Fix your disgusting habits that you hide from the internet instead of hyping someone up that you just use for your thumbnails. Also on September 23rd, paparazzi spoke with Dixie and Noah. Paparazzi claims Noah and Dixie were blushing as they were answering questions about each other.
He's nice, he's funny and hardworking, I don't know.
She's super caring. It kind of goes with it, but like, she's always there. Like, if you have a problem, she's always there for you. She's super sweet, like, and she's like super genuine. She's very real.
Do you think they were blushing? On September 24th, Dixie was approached by paparazzi again. Dixie was asked if she was on good terms with Griffin.
I don't think so, but I'm chilling.
And that's all for now. What do you think of the story? Wow, Matcha, that was a lot. Tell me your thoughts in the comments below.